He's Plexity, and today we played a game called Naruto Ultimate Edition 4, yo!
Hello, it's Plexity, and today...
Yeah, this is Plexity, and today...
Plexity!
This is Plexity.
Boy, Plexity.
Goody!
It is Plexity. Yo. It is your boy Plexity. Never stop Plexity, bro. And you know, through that montage, that was my whole experience of just on YouTube until now, bro. I mean, not my whole thing, because you know, there's a lot of channels that I've deleted in the past, so you know, it's not up. So yeah, I have, you know, I've been here long enough, you feel me? 2021, bro, another year. And another year goes by with consecration, you know? Man, it's been a journey. It's been definitely a journey. It has its ups, it has its downs. But the best thing ever is that it taught me. I think that's the most keyest thing. Through all these, you know, good times, to the sad times, to the stressful times, to the very depressed times, and build character. It would really have built character and the person that I am today, you know? And would I do all of that? Would I just be like, I'm a failure? Should I quit? I didn't reach my destination yet, yada, yada, yada. Should I go that route, of which that mindset has been there for a very, very long time. And that I've been looking at the destination for a very, very long time, but instead of feeling the journey or feeling the absolute love and embracing 100% of the love of creativeness and just my 100% passion. Like, my passion was there, like during the times my passion was there, but it was numbed by the mindset of like, you know, I need to, like, let me stop feeling excited for this shit. Let me stop feeling excited for editing. Let me stop feeling excited for recording a video. Let me stop feeling excited for doing all of this content creation just for that one simple fact that, quote unquote, I didn't make my destination yet. And if I don't make my destination, then I'm not a YouTuber or I'm not a content creator. You know, my life is not fulfilled until I see that number right there specifically. And that is definitely a toxic ass mindset to have. And if you just tunnel vision towards a number, then just branch out into other things, you know, open that tunnel up and see what's around you, feel me? Feel that, you know, see that awareness of everything, you know. If you just focus on that one thing, then you don't see the puzzles that you should be putting together to make you embrace it as fully as it should, you know? You're only seeing that one puzzle while there's other puzzles, like, right next to you or right behind you, you know? But you don't want to turn your neck. You don't want to turn this way. You don't want to turn that way. You do not want to look behind you because you're too focused on this, like the number. You're too focused on the number, you know? That definitely has been my mindset because I didn't understand. I haven't understood what grinding truly meant. You know, I thought grinding was like, you know, let me grind to this number, let me grind to that milestone, let me grind to this milestone, you know? Numbers are numbers that is out of your control, pretty much. Like, you could one day go up, it could another day go down, it could go up, it could go down, it could go up, it could go down. Like, numbers is out of your control. The only thing you control is your behavior to things, you know? The only thing that you can control is how you react to things. And that's also another key factor of being present, you know? And if you're just looking and reacting to the numbers going up and going down, you're going to be, like, you know, focus on something that's out of your control, then of course you're going to be thrown off. You're going to continuously thrown off. You'd be like, yeah, I'm doing something good. And then, yeah, I'm doing something bad. I'm doing something bad. Then, yeah, I'm doing something good. Then, nah, I'm doing something bad, you know? But there's going to be that endless loop of, like, just, you know, just endless loop of, like, up and down. Like, the same way as, like, a business scale goes. Like, it goes up, then another day it goes down, then it goes up, then it goes down, then it goes up, then it goes down. That's going to be your emotions if you keep messing it up. And your emotions is going to be too jumbled up the point where you're not going to function, you know? You truly are not going to function. That this month, I truly had to take it all back, you know, just step back, pretty much. It was like, you know, let me really, truly analyze this, you know? Let me really, truly self-reflect on everything that's been going on, because the biggest question that I asked myself through this month was like, did I continue? You know, the most powerful last question that I asked myself was, should I continue? Like, you're about to make it another year of content creation. Look at, you know, self-reflect on your mindset, self-reflect where you are, your channel, your content creation, self-reflect on who you are as a person, and answer, like, you know, answer this question. Should you continue? Yes or no? And I really had, like, you know, with this corona and everything, you know, corona sucks ass, but I feel like 2020 was definitely a time period to be like, sit on this, like, sit to yourself, be by yourself. You know, the other years, 2019 and like way back then, you was outside with people, you was outside, you was talking to people, you was like being an extrovert, you was just you was just with other people. But 2020 was definitely a year to be like, hey, time for you to sit back and reflect on your life right now, where you at right now, and analyze, and, you know, find the truth within yourself, you know? Because usually we go on autopilot. So, like, most of the times we do go on autopilot. And that autopilot, you know, you ignore a lot of things, you know? You ignore a lot of things. You're automatic. You're like a robot machine. And then once autopilot disengaged, you probably, you know, like, for a brief second, you're probably somewhere, you know, like, some trying something new, or somewhere trying something that's uncomfortable. Usually when you're not in autopilot, it's usually when you don't understand something, or you're in a new experience. Going into autopilot, it's a numb feeling. It's definitely a numb feeling. It's definitely truly a numb feeling. Like, this year has definitely, you know, made autopilot disengage happen through this whole year of 2020. And I truly had to sit back and, you know, and sometimes question my mindset. Like, there was no noise, there was no loud people. It was just me, my room, by myself, just hearing what I was thinking, seeing what I was doing on autopilot mode, seeing how I was moving. And definitely I was not moving as a content creator. I was moving like as if I was moving as if I was in third person watching somebody, like, not even watching myself, pretty much. I was pretty much watching a total stranger, because I didn't really know myself at the time of 2020. And I feel like now, like, through just me sitting back and relaxing and just thinking, you know, just analyzing my thoughts and just seeing where I'm at, you know, it really just brought a whole new perspective of myself. It was like, whoa, I'm not even controlling myself. I am watching myself. And that's a different perception indeed. It's like you're fighting to control your own body. Like, sometimes your thoughts be like, yo, like, it be on the right track. And then sometimes, like, you know, your conscious and your subconscious be fighting each other, pretty much, to say who's in the right and who's in the wrong. Subconscious being the person that has, you know, that goes by routine or daily, you know, habits and such, while the conscious, which is the present right now, is be like, yo, You're not yourself. What are you doing? This is not what you want to do. You know, it's, you know, they having a conflict to be like, no, these habits are what this dude was doing, and it has been working for him, quote unquote. And so the both mindsets been battling on with each other, and to the point where it could definitely feel like a war within your mind, you know. But then if you sit back and relax and hear their two point of views, and then just be like, you know what, I want to create me. Instead of finding me, I want to create me. Like, that's what I follow always. Is like, you don't need to find yourself, just create yourself. Change that new bio up, you know. Don't let something, some entity or something, just try to control you or try to be like, you know, on autopilot doing the things that you know you shouldn't do, or you know you don't want to do. This year has been just a self-reflection, and the key point of it is, with more the new mindset that I have birthed with now, that is truly going to make my year or make my life more colorful, is that to just be in the present, you know, just be in the present, be in the journey. Make a goal. You can still be like, you know, I want to lose 10 pounds, or I want to have like, you know, 10,000, you know, subscribers by the end of this year. But just know, like, don't let it consume you, you know? Don't let it consume you. It's not everything. It isn't everything. It's just a number, you know? It's just a number that goes up and down. The fact of the matter is that the life is right now. Your feelings is right now. Focus on the things that's right now. Do not connect your feelings to future events that never even happened. Do not connect your feelings onto things that is uncontrolling, you know? Watch, like, just be your behavior right now, you know? Feel the feeling of editing. Feel the feeling of listening, like, creating your own music, creating your own brand. Feel the love and joy of you doing the craft right now instead of focusing on that number. That number or anything that's out of your control is just going to control you, you know? And that was pretty much what this year had taught me, is just be in a journey, be yourself, love this content creation. Another big question was, if you didn't even make it, bro, if you didn't even make it at all, would you still be doing this shit? Like, the numbers and everything, would you still be doing this shit? Would you still have fun? Would you still love this? And to be honest, yes, I would still, like, if I don't even make it, bro, I would still love the fuck out of this. And that's the truest answer that you need to seek, is that regardless if you have 1 million subscribers, 1,000 subscribers, or whatever, it doesn't dictate, you know, who you are as a person. You know, like a YouTube, like, you know, you don't need to have like 1,000 or 1 million or some shit to be a YouTuber. You're a YouTuber, bro. Like, the moment you sign in, and the moment you create a video, the moment you fell in love with the shit that you're doing right now, you are a YouTuber, bro. Or you are the thing. You are your passion. You are your craft. And the craft loves you. And for being within that relationship with you and your craft, you gotta feel each other, you know? You gotta feel each other's auras, each other's vibrations, each other's, you know, you gotta feel it. You gotta feel it in the present to actually fell in love with it and continue it. You gotta love your passion. Do not treat your passion as your destination. Be within the journey and take this shit step by step, you know? And I know I was probably rambling on a lot, but I just had, you know, I just had a lot on my mind, pretty much. I just had a lot on my mind. The key is that just be in the present, you know, love everything, love the sky, love the sunset, love recording, be like, you know, just, you know, love recording, love everything right now. Do not wait for a destination that you want to go to then start loving it, you know? Then, you know, ignoring the journey is going to make the destination be like, yo, why don't I feel this way? It's because that you was not paying attention to the journey, you know? And you just focus on that destination and you just ignored all the feelings and made yourself numb. And then now when it happened, you're like, you question it, do I really deserve it or not? Because you forgot what you've been working so hard for. You forgot the feeling of working hard. But yeah, yo, happy 2020. I'm definitely gonna kill this shit this year with this new mindset and with this new, you know, I feel like I love content creation now. I love it. I fucking love it now. I love it now, bro. We've been here for a very, very, very long time. And, you know, if you ask me if am I gonna quit? Fuck no, I'm not gonna quit, bro. I'm not gonna quit. I'm gonna continue to do this shit to the day that I die, because this, I've been doing this for ever since I was a kid, 2009. And I'm gonna continue to keep doing it. I'm gonna continue to kill the game of my creativity. I'm gonna continue to use my special, you know, my special uniqueness and try to, you know, just branch out, you feel me? And spread my wings, because I just love this content creation. And I want to show everybody, you know, that I love this shit, you feel me? This is Plex City again. Happy New Year's. And I'm going to be definitely more consistent. Your boy is definitely going to get that, you know, it's going to get some upgrades, you feel me? But overall, like, I love each and every one of you guys. And I'm going to never trade you guys for the world. I'm also thinking about changing, you know, Plexi Gang. I'm also changing that as well. I'm thinking about it. It might come soon. The idea might come soon, but I'm still thinking about it. But anyway, this is your boy Plexity. Your boy's out. I mean, 2021, we're going to kill this shit, you know? Jesus, man.